Coming up next on the Jeff Crilley Show, nationwide there is a problem filling jobs, but Dallas College is coming to the rescue. That's just ahead.
Many are predicting that the worst is yet to come, which is unfortunate, said one person here. Until now, they've enjoyed the reputation of being the nation's icebox.
Watched a burglar in his home this morning by webcam.
As a journalist of over 25 years, stories are what make my world turn.
Reporting live from the Dallas Newsroom tonight, Jeff Crilley, Fox 4 News.
But in 2008, I took the jump from my familiar life and started a PR firm from my home.
We're talking about anyone with a camcorder like the one I'm using becomes a television network.
We started slowly growing the company, and we now have over 100 clients, and we've branched into the world of live digital broadcasting. I now own 8 different TV studios and have a huge team, and the stories that I now get to share are sometimes the most important of my life. Life has a funny way of coming around full circle. This is the Jeff Crilley Show.
Well, I can't remember a time in my lifetime when so many jobs have gone unfilled. And to talk about that today, Dr. Joe Seabrooks, he is the president of Cedar Valley Campus of Dallas College. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you. It's my pleasure to be here. I really appreciate this opportunity. You're absolutely right. We're at a crisis. In my humble opinion, our greatest threat to our region, our country, the world is having an available workforce. And if we're not careful, we're going to slip into a point of no return, and that wouldn't be good for anyone.
And when there's people out there saying, well, people are lazy, people don't want jobs, that's not true. You've got a bunch of hungry students who want employment.
Absolutely, and it's about matching people with the right opportunity. And the way we're doing it now, we're just kind of throwing it out, rolling the ball out there and see who would sign up. But really, we're strategically focused in analyzing students, their interests, their abilities, their orientations, their tendencies, and matching them with the right opportunities and providing the training up front so they can hit the ground running.
You have some very innovative programs, and we'll talk about that in a minute, but let's go ahead and run a student testimonial.
A lot of people that I went to school with, I was homeschooled in high school. It was just kind of something we did to get dual credit out of the way. We didn't have a system to go through like regular public schools did when they bussed us over. It was just part of us. We had an association, and a large amount of those students went to Cedar Valley or other DCCC schools in order to have themselves prepared for college. The flexibility of the schedule was something that I had as a homeschooler, but it was a different way. You know, in most public schools or even in private schools, it's a very regimented schedule, and here you could build it your own way, and that really helped as a transition into college when I got to a 4-year university. After I finished at Cedar Valley, it was always something that I was gonna go to school, whether it was a 2-year or a 4-year after high school. I knew I was gonna go to college, I just didn't know where. The school that I ended up going to, Texas Wesleyan, kind of fell on my plate late in my senior year, and a lot of my credits transferred from Cedar Valley, so I was really lucky to do that. Coming back to the community after leaving Cedar Valley the first time, it's been a different viewpoint that I have. When I left after high school, you know, I was fresh going into college, I was a little bit younger, I really didn't know exactly what I was going to do, and now I'm teaching in the area in Duncanville, and so a lot of the students that I have there are students that are going to be coming to Cedar Valley as well. It's the same type of kids that are coming out of Lancaster and even surrounding Dallas ISD schools. Hi, my name is Alex Lopez, and I'm a former student of Cedar Valley College.
It's okay to not know what's coming next. But one thing is for sure, whether you are looking for an associate's degree, a certification, or an advisor to help you figure it out, we've got your back. Cedar Valley College, your next step is here. Register for fall at cedarvalleycollege.edu.
That is so inspiring, and you literally have 10,000 stories just like that. 10,000 students go to your campus.
Absolutely. 10,000 students at the Cedar Valley campus and over 85,000 at the entire 7 campus college.
That's amazing, and I think most people underestimate Dallas College. They didn't realize it's so big. I mean, that puts it among the biggest universities in the state.
In the country, actually.
Is that right?
Absolutely. So we're between us and there's Arizona Miami-Dade.
No kidding. That is so impressive. Let's talk about some of your innovative programs. The one that touches my heart is your program for returning citizens.
Yeah, absolutely. So we partner with the Regional Black Contractors Association, and we developed a 5-week construction trades program. In that program, they get NCCER, which is the trade certification for construction, but they also get OSHA certification. So in 5 weeks, they go from not having any experience in the construction trades to being highly sought after, right, hitting the ground running, being productive right away.
And that's so important, because even the construction industry is having to pump the brakes because they don't have enough skilled labor. So you're really meeting a critical need right now.
Absolutely, and we cannot afford for the construction industry to pump the brakes. Literally, TxDOT has over $30 billion with the projects that are coming online in the DFW in the next 4 or 5 years. And we can't afford not to have people ready and available, prepared to work.
Tell us about your BankWorks program.
So BankWorks is a phenomenal program. It's 12 weeks. And in those 12 weeks, individuals learn the ins and outs about the banking profession. And in 12 weeks, they're prepared to enter any retail bank in the region. And they do so at about a 95% job placement rate.
Any other programs you want to put a spotlight on?
Oh man, so many. I don't know how much time we have, but let me just I'll just share a couple. So the Innovation Center is located in the 75216 zip code, across from the VA Center. It used to be the old Urban League building, and we have worked with Emmett Smith Company to renovate it. And on October 20th. At 6 p.m., we'll have our grand opening, and we will be doing amazing programs, construction trades, advanced manufacturing. And I'm not talking about it's robots, it's robotics, it's hydraulics, it's the stuff that people earn a fantastic living at, and in industrial maintenance. And these are all jobs that are high wage, high need, high demand, and are background friendly. And so we're matching the jobs and the opportunities with the folks who need them the most, and getting them prepared to hit the ground running. And so, you know, people, they've paid their dues to society, and we're happy to help them integrate back into society, to help them be productive and move our society forward.
And when you say hit the ground running, Emmett Smith knows a little something about
that's
that.
That's right, absolutely, absolutely.
He's a good person to partner with. Any other programs you wanna put a spotlight on before we move on?
Oh man, in addition to that, over in the South Dallas Training Center, which is located in Fair Park, again, 75210, probably the most vulnerable economic zip code in our region. I mean, the average household income is $21,000 a year. In 2021, that's hard to believe. Well, the programs we'll be doing there is transportation and logistics. We'll also be doing some entry level to advanced manufacturing, and GED and ESL there as well. And again, we taking the education to the people who need it the most, and we're just thrilled to be in that space.
Well, your eyes light up when you talk about this subject. I mean, it's a passion for you, isn't it?
It's more than a passion, it's a calling. You know, we have a unique opportunity to help those who need us the most to get placed in an opportunity where we need them the most. And if we can't afford to leave anyone out of the equation when it comes to our workforce. And that's what Dallas College has been about for almost 55 years. And I'm just thrilled to be a part of the movement.
Outstanding. And we want to put a spotlight on some media coverage that you got recently. The Dallas Morning News featured you. You're very active in the community in general. Tell us about this event.
Yeah, so this was the Juneteenth celebration. I think it's been a while since we've had that celebration at this size. And we partnered with Elite Media News. I think we were a premier sponsor in that, and it was a fantastic a way of honoring our transition from slavery to being citizens in this country, and we're proud to be a part of that movement.
Outstanding. Talk a little bit about COVID and how you coped, because I don't know if it was this past year, you had a virtual graduation, is that right?
Yeah, so 2 years ago, I mean, so right when COVID hit, we scrambled trying to figure out how do we honor the accomplishments accomplishments of our students, particularly in COVID. And I tell you, we had a team of phenomenal folks from marketing, from the student development folks, faculty, the academic enterprise team, and put together what I believe is an outstanding virtual graduation. It really shows how we can pivot on a dime to make sure that we honor the folks who deserve to be honored. And this past year, we were able to be in person, but we had to break it up into seven ceremonies, which we weren't quite sure how that was going to work. But I tell you, the young and the young at heart who earned those credentials, their families were so very proud of them. And again, that's our New Year's Eve. That's our Christmas. It's the most exciting time. And if you've never been to a Dallas College commencement ceremony, you really hadn't lived, because I get goosebumps just thinking about the stories and the inspiration from the students who are again from 18 to you know 65, who are using Dallas College as a way to figure out how they can be more engaging in our society.
I love it. If there's somebody watching right now, and we only have about a minute left, or somebody watching saying, maybe I'm watching this for a reason, maybe I should be a part of this movement, what's the next step for them?
Oh man, the next step, visit our website, dallascollege.edu. If you've never had any college at all, don't let that discourage you. If you don't even have a high school diploma, don't let that discourage you. If English is not your first language and you haven't mastered it, don't let that discourage you. We will match you with the program that you need at the point that you are. There's nothing under the sun that we can't help you and guide you with to help you strengthen your pathway to success.
Well, thank you so much for coming into studio.
Oh, my pleasure.
And when you say that this is your calling, I feel it.
Thank you.
Thank you for giving back the way you do. Dr. Joe Seabrooks, president of Cedar Valley campus of Dallas College. We're going to end with the website, which is dallascollege.edu. And Dr. Seabrooks, thanks one more time.
Thank you. My pleasure.
You bet. And that's it for now. We'll see you next time. We'll be right back.